Okay, we are now 4 Yakuza games in. My goal was to play and review each of the mainline entries before the end of the year. And now that we completed Yakuza 3, we are one step closer to that goal. Yakuza 0 still remains my favorite so far, with Kiwami 2 right behind that. So let's see how Yakuza 3 stacks up with these amazing games. So one thing to note, even though these games are available on modern consoles with the remastering of 3, 4, and 5, these are simply remasters and not remakes like the Kiwami games. This trilogy was originally released for PS3, and to be honest, Sega did a good job remastering these games. Do they look as good as a Dragon Engine title? No, but the visuals still hold up for me. More on that later, but now let's get into the game itself. So starting with the plot, like my previous Yakuza reviews, I would not be giving many spoilers for those who are looking to play this game or currently playing this game. Yakuza games tend to be filled with tons of twists and turns, so it's always best to experience these games firsthand if possible, but let's go ahead and give a quick rundown and my opinion of the plot. So Yakuza 3 takes place a few years after the events of Yakuza 2. Kiru is now in charge of the Morning Glory Orphanage, alongside his adopted daughter, Hakura. Kiru is continuing on the path to helping kids who are orphans just like he was. You spend a great deal of time at Okinawa, and you really grow an attachment to all the kids in the orphanage, and I was really invested in many of the subplots surrounding this theme. One thing about Yakuza 3, the setting of the game is very relaxing to me. This was a great change of pace from the typical Komorocho or Sodomberry runs. I love the beach, especially during the nighttime. I also love the small beach town feel that this area has. Now, you do eventually make your way back to Komorocho, but I really enjoyed my time at Okinawa. It was so relaxing and it was a great change of pace. However, the main plot is very similar to Yakuza 0, where we are fighting over land once again. In this case, Kiru's orphanage is threatened and also the residents of Okinawa. One side wants to build a resort to push the tourist dollars, and others want to push a military base to draw an illegal arms syndicate. Of course, the Tojo clan is involved. So again, Yakuza keeps the overall theme of a power struggle, and Kiru is somehow dragged right back into this. This man really can't catch a break. Many of the main characters you come to know and love from this series are here. Majima and his crazy antics, Daigo, Hakura, and now even the new characters, the kids from the orphanage, and how can we even forget Ricky? Again, the writing and the characters are very memorable, and I love seeing these characters interact with each other. The standout characters for me were actually the kids. In the midst of all the chaos going on, the subplots with the children really bring some much needed relief from all of that nonsense. Now for the gameplay. Like I stated earlier, this is just a prettier port of the PS3 game. Now there are some localization differences, but in terms of the combat and such, that remain for the most part untouched. If you're coming from Yakuza 0, Kiwami 1, and definitely Kiwami 2, this can feel a little bit more bare bones in comparison. There's no multiple fighting styles, the heat moves are not as explosive, and Kiru only has one movement speed while exploring. So take that in consideration when you start and play Yakuza 3. For me personally, I thought going into this the controls were gonna feel super stiff, but honestly, no. I had no issues with how this game controlled, and even though the combat was not as engaging as it was in previous games, I still had a very fun time with it. You could still pick up things like furniture and bikes to destroy your enemies and use finishing heat moves similar to Kiwami 2. The one complaint that I do have, the enemies here, they love to block. This makes boss fights and other fights drag out for far too long. Not as bad or annoying as Kiwami 1, but it's still a headache. Kiru can still level up by winning fights, eating, and completing sub-stories. Now, one thing this game does better in my opinion, the sub-stories are not as annoying as the ones of previous games. In Yakuza 0, if you walk past a sub-story, the game would literally stop you in your tracks to interact with that person. Not so much here. The sub-stories are marked on the map, but it's up to you to find them and go do them. Also, random thug encounters are not as frequent in this game, so make sure you grind when you can. You still have many things to distract yourself, like the cabaret club, karaoke, and even Club Sega. I didn't really bother with many of the side activities, but as you guys know, I love Club Sega. But this time we have an original title called Boxless. Pretty fun game, and it's a pretty good looking game. You also have these chase missions, which are fun, but can get a little difficult. The one that comes to mind is when Kiru has to run from the cops, or when one of the kids run away from the orphanage. It's a fun little mini game that kind of breaks up the gameplay, but is also very challenging as well. Now, the boss fights. Again, the combat is not as flashy as the last couple Yakuza games I played, but there are still some very intense and fun boss fights here. The standouts for me was of course Keita in the Love Hotel. I also love the returning boss, Lau Ka Long. I hope I said his name right. He was the standout boss for me in Kiwami 1, so I was glad to see him make a return here. The final boss fight was also pretty intense. In pure Yakuza fashion, we throw hands shirtless on top of a roof. Very intense and very fun boss fight. Overall, Yakuza 3 was a good experience. There were some things that I really enjoyed. I love seeing the other side of Kiryu. With him being a father figure and being there for those kids, look, I wouldn't mind playing a whole game where that was the main focus. The change of location was a welcome addition, and I found Okinawa to be really relaxing, and it was a welcome change of pace. The combat system is not as fleshed out as in the Kiwami games, but again, this game came out way before those games, so you have to take that into consideration. The story outside of the orphanage was not really that interesting to me, but it had its key moments. This is a mainline entry, so play this and see what Kiryu was up to after Kiwami 2. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.